Hi, hello, namaskara. In this session, we'll be dealing with Stokes' theorem. So if you remember, in our electrostatics, we had discussed about divergence theorem. So the Stokes' theorem is analogous to that of the divergence theorem in my magnetostatics. So Stokes' theorem is related with respect to the line integral and the surface integral, wherein if you remember in my divergence theorem, so if I relate divergence theorem, close surface integral of d dot ds was equal to the volume integral of del dot d times dv. So there, if you see, I was getting the relation between my surface integral and volume integral. So similarly, in my Stokes theorem, I will be relating my line integral to surface integral. So I'll let you know how that is done. So before going to this, in our sessions on curl, we had derived the expression for curl. So if you remember the expression for a curl, the expression for curl was defined like this. The general expression was my limit delta s, that is the area which tends to zero, where I had my line integral or closed line integral of h dot dl over that surface was given by what? It was equal to the current density, which was nothing but the curl of my magnetic flux, I mean the magnetic field intensity. Or if I just equate this part, forgetting the current density, this was the general form of my expression that we had discussed in the concept of curl. So if you see this, I can now relate the whole equation in the surface integral form. Ask me how. So this is nothing but h dot dl. So if I take this to the RHS and if I take the integral, then this becomes the surface integral of del cross h times ds. So this is the actual statement of my Stokes theorem, okay, wherein basically the Stokes theorem states the line integral of a vector h around a closed path. The line integral of a vector h around a closed path is equal to the integral of the curl over an open surface. The integral of that particular vector h over a surface. Okay. So basically here I have related the line integral to the surface integral. So to explain you with the proof, so I'll try to give the proof of it. So what you can do is, I'll be considering a surface, okay? I mean, I'll be taking a surface, and this surface is having a path. So if I want to represent the path might be something like this. At the boundary, I have a path. So if I can tell this as a closed path, okay, which is enclosing a surface. So this will be a surface that I have. So what can I do in this is, basically I want to solve for this surface. So surface will be having a vector which I'll be calling the normal vector. So if I take a small area around it, so this is my area ds and this is the direction of that particular area, or the vector, directional vector of that particular area. So I want to prove that the above equation for a Stokes theorem holds good. So for that, what I do is, I basically take this area, okay, I'll take this area, I can use this thing like this, and for solving I'll be splitting this area into small differential surfaces. So I can call now this has a small differential surface, this is another small differential surface, this is another small differential surface. Likewise, I have many differential surfaces, okay? Many, many differential surfaces. What I do is, I try to solve for each and every surface. So if I zoom it further ahead, say for example, I have something like this, okay? I first try to solve for this surface area. So when I apply my Ampere circuit law, the path I'm taking will be, assume that the current is flowing in this direction, that is, it is coming out of the screen. So if I take the right hand rule, the path will be, the closed line will be taken something like this, okay? So now what I do is, this is my first solution. For the second solution, I'll go with the second surface area. Again, now here I'm going to take the closed path with respect to this. So if you see this, there is a cancellation in between. So if you see this particular point in between here, okay, in between here, so you can actually see a cancellation happening of the path. So if you just see it in the overview, it is something like a closed path which looks something like this, and your area will be twice of delta S, or it is two deltas. You have one delta S here, the other delta S. So I have taken up a bigger area. Again, now if I apply the same circuital law here, I'll be traversing this path now. So as you can see now, this will be getting cancelled off. So this part will be getting cancelled off, and the area have been grown now something like this. This is the path I have taken after step 3. So if you see this, as and when I keep on calculating for each and every blocks, I'm actually taking the complete path at the end of my integration or summing up. It is something like, I have a figure here. So I'm starting with say one, again second area. So when I take the two areas, this is my surface. When I start with the third area, my area will be added up here. And the fourth area, you can think of, if I take this as the fourth area, okay, this is the fourth area, then my whole area will be increased to this. If I take this is fifth and this is sixth, again my area will be increased to this particular ratio. As and when I keep on iterating the areas, I mean the surfaces, at the end of the iteration, I will be getting the complete external path. So that means to say, if I want to calculate for this whole surface, I'll be taking a small portions of incremental surface, and I'm keep on integrating, and at the end I'll be getting the final surface or the total surface. So that is one concept to solve this. So what I do is, for a small portion of that particular area, so assume that I have taken this small portion, for this small portion I'll be applying the curl. So for that small portion, curl of H, which has a normal component, can be written as the general form, closed loop integral of H dot dl with that particular smaller area. The dl is the distance that I have traveled on the line, the closed line, okay? So that is the only distance. So this outer path is the only distance I have traveled, okay? So this is the only distance, so that is dl by delta s, the whole divided by the actual surface delta s. So what I do is, I'll just take this over here. Before taking this, what is this delta, the curl of H, what is this? It's not delta, it's curl. What is this curl? Curl of H with normal component can be written as this. So I'm calculating the curl of H for that particular normal component, wherein if I take this delta S, this is my solution, where closed line integral of H dot dl will remain as it is for that particular area. But what is this n cap del S? If I say this is my del S and this is my n cap, can I say this as a vector del s or the area vector. So ds vector can be written as ds times n cap, where n cap is my unit vector of that particular area and this is the magnitude. So if I represent this as magnitude and the unit vector, I can write this whole thing as what? I can represent this as delta s the vector. So now I'm okay, I'll write it in another color. So this whole term can be written as delta of s vector. Now this whole thing has become to a vector form, and this is del cross h, I mean the curl of h, which is equal to closed line integral of h dot dl for that particular small. So what I have done is, if I have considered this and if I applied my Ampere's circuit law for this small part, only for this small part, I have got the closed line integral is nothing but the rotation of magnetic field around that particular surface. So that's what this curl of H over that surface. So if I integrate, as I said, I'll be taking the second surface, I'll be taking the third surface, fourth surface, so on and so forth. If I keep on integrating more and more, I'll be ending up at what? So as I keep on integrating more and more, this whole expression will be summed up, like this cancel out will be happening, equal and opposite direction cancel will be having, and I'll be getting the final expression. So the final expression will be nothing but the whole integral or the surface integral of the curl of H over the surface ds will be equal to the closed line integral of h dot dl. So this is the concept of my Ampere circuit law, wherein it basically ends up getting me the total surface. So if I start from the inner box, I can explain here, if I start from the inner box, I'll be taking the second box, third box, and so on and so forth. As I keep on integrating, at the end of my iteration, I will be ending up but following this whole line, right? When I get this whole line, I have actually covered the whole surface. So I am now trying to compare the line integral, that is the closed line integral to the surface integral. That's what Stokes' theorem proved. So the surface integral should always be equal to the line integral, hence this expression, where dl is the perimeter of that whole surface and ds is the actual surface. Okay, so the key note here is that the Stokes' theorem is only applicable to the open surface enclosed by a closed path. Okay, this is an open surface. The surface which we saw, if I take a surface like this, this is open surface which is enclosed by a closed path. So the path here is closed. So this is where the application of Stokes' theorem holds good, and that's about Stokes' theorem. If you have any queries or any doubts regarding this, please do some research, contact me, I'll let you know. Go through some of the resources, go to your textbook. Hope I have conveyed the concept properly over here and I have made you understand the thing. Thank you.